Hey Wildcats, it's your girl Maya from the girls' varsity basketball team. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please have a seat for a moment of silence.
Hey, ITV News, ITV News,
ITV News,
ITV News,
ITV.
What's up, Wildcats? I'm your host, Marcus.
And I'm Isamari.
And this is your ITV News.
Club News.
Here's a list of all the clubs happening today after school.
Mysterious and spooky, they're all together, Wookie, the Addams Family.
Marcus, I hear Key Club has some important news to tell us.
Word?
Yes. Show them.
Roll the clip.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Basketball. There'll be a girls' basketball intramurals in the back of the gym today at 1:30 to 3:30. This is open to any and all girls who are interested in playing basketball. If you have any questions, see Coach Rafer in the gym.
Baseball news.
If you're interested in playing baseball this school year, please join us for an important meeting today at 1:30 in Portable 624. Hope to see you there.
Pickleball tournament.
Join us for an exciting pickleball tournament on November 9th at 2:30 p.m. Sign-ups are now open. To participate, please contact Ms. Cascanet in room 410. Don't miss out on the fun. Get your team together and register today.
Halloween news.
Get ready for a spooktacular event today from 6 to 9. The JRTC is hosting a Halloween party. It'll promise you chills and thrills. Get your $5 tickets from the breakers and bring your student IDs. Join us for the Monster Mask Dance and Costume Contest. There will also be food, drinks, and snacks available. And who else will be there? DJ Chaos. Come on, don't miss out. Don't ghost this event, like I told you. See you there. Don't miss out on a chance to honor your loved ones, Wildcats. Remember, be there or be square.
College news.
During both lunches, there will be a workshop on starting your FAFSA in the College and Career Center inside the library. If you need monies for colleges and will be completing the FAFSA forms, come to the workshop for more information.
So I think in the moment of my parents like sitting us down and talking, my mom had breast cancer. I felt fearful because I didn't understand what was going on. And with that does come hurt feelings and hard times, but I try to always remember that.
Mrs. Sualua, can you tell us of a time when you faced adversity?
Let's see, I'm 40. So I've had a lot of adversity in my life. I would say a time when I had adversity, maybe when my mom had breast cancer. I was in my late 20s, like I'd already graduated from getting my master's and everything. So I was at like a good place in my life, and then bam, this happens. And I think that's always what happens, right? Is when like you think everything is going great and you're doing what you're supposed to do, like life throws you a curveball. So I think in the moment of my parents like sitting us down and talking, I felt fearful because fear of the unknown. I had never been through anything like medically with my family. So I was, you know, fearful of that because I didn't understand what was going on. My mom's like universe of our family and she like bonds us all together. So obviously like I was scared of that. I just had a lot of racing questions going through my mind and trying to compartmentalize where to get answers from.
Tell us about your resilience when dealing with this adversity, and how did it make you stronger?
dealing with it and making myself stronger, I think being mindful and just living in the day helped me a lot to process what was going on, but also be able to have hope while giving myself some grace. I think that when you go through like trials and tribulations, like there's a lot of growth that you can learn from it, but you have to be open to that. And with that does come hurt feelings and hard times. But I try to always remember that it's time and it's gonna pass. This isn't forever. And even though I'm feeling this way, doesn't mean that I have to act on it. I can just let my feelings pass.
If you could tell students one lesson that overcoming this adversity taught you, what would it be?
Like I was saying before, time is, it's gonna pass eventually. How you get through it and the tools that you use and your learning through life is really what matters. I think that even though I've been through those things, not like I'm like, you know, I wouldn't have changed it. Like, obviously I would have, but like, I'm definitely a stronger person and I feel like I can get through more because I've been through hard things. I don't think that I'm an exception. Everybody has hard things that they go through at different levels, and it's all about perception. My perception of me going through with my family was super hard, but I might have more support than somebody else. So it's, I think it has a lot to do with perception as well.
Wildcat Market.
This week, join us for the Wildcat Market this Friday during both lunches. Support our various clubs by purchasing items from them. I'm Issa Mari.
And I'm Marcus.
And this was UITV News.
Wildcats, pay attention.
Bye.
Thanks for watching.